Dear students, welcome back to my YouTube channel Remedial Classes. Today I have come up with grammar section and I shall start with tense. Please do like, share and subscribe. What is tense? Verb form that shows the time of an action is called tense. And what is a verb? All action words are known as verb. For example, eat, sleep, walk, run, etc. There can be no sentences without a verb. Only in case of exclamatory sentences like wonderful, marvelous, etc. No verb is required. Again, tense is divided into three groups: present tense, past tense and future tense. Again, these tenses are subdivided into four heads like present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect continuous. In the same manner, past indefinite, past continuous, past perfect continuous, future indefinite, future continuous, future perfect and future perfect continuous. So what do you understand by tense? Tense is time and work. And who decides the work? Work is decided by the verb. So let's start with present indefinite tense and its uses. Present indefinite tense is used in case of regular uses like habitual action, like I usually speak truth. My grandmother reads a book once a week. He usually goes to the temple on Monday. These are all habitual action of a person. Next, it is used in case of universal truth, like water freezes at 0 degrees centigrade. The earth moves around the sun. The sun sets in the west, etc. Then it is used in case of a nature of a particular person. For example, she speaks English fluently. He does not speak Spanish. He is a good runner. She is a good cook. These are the examples of a nature of a person. And the another one is that about the permanent things which exists. For example, this road leads to Amritsar. Agra, the Taj stands at Agra. The river Brahmaputra flows through Assam. These are all permanent things which will never be changed. These are all present indefinite tense. So in case of present indefinite tense, you can use words like usually, never, ever, every day, daily. Whenever you come across words which are using this usually, every day and all, you can understand that it is present indefinite tense. Now let's know the formula. Before knowing the formula, you have to understand about the singular and plural. Singular and plural. First person singular number and first person plural number. These are all very important, otherwise you will not understand. For example, first person singular number is I, first person plural number is we, second person singular is you, second person plural is also you, third person singular is he or she, and third person plural is they. These are very important. Now we have to use some certain rules are there in using es as suffix to some words. For example, words which ends with ch, ss, x and o, their es suffix is used, like bench, bench. When it is, it will be converted into the plural form, you have to use like benches, benches. Then if it is class, 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 it will be classes because the words ends with ss. If it is box, 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 you will use boxes. If it is go, as it ends with o, you have to use goes. And in case of other words which ends with consonants, you have to use only s, like table, tables, chairs, chairs, fan, fans. These are the things you have to remember. Now let's know about the construction of present indefinite tense. The construction is subject plus verb plus object. Subject is like I, then verb is eat, then object is rice. Now only in case of third person singular number you have to use the word s. Like I eat rice, then the same will remain in case of we eat rice. You also, it will remain the same thing, you eat rice. In case of he, you have to write He eats rice. And they, it will be same, they eat rice. So simple, I eat rice is very simple, everybody eats rice, very simple to remember. So I have taken the very simple words to explain it clearly. Now next, move on to present continuous tense. What do we understand by present continuous tense? Present continuous tense means work which is continuous, in continuous process, means progressing. Like I eat rice will be changed into like I am eating rice. Again, it is like work which is in progress but not necessarily at the time of speaking. For example, what is your brother doing these days? He is writing a book on grammar. These are the present continuous tense. Again, present continuous tense is used for a particular person who does the mistakes continuously. Like she is committing mistakes these days. He is backbiting. So these are the works in progress. And it is also used for action which are planned for near future. For example, I am not inviting her to my party. We are visiting a theater hall next week. Let's start with present perfect tense and its uses. What is present perfect tense? The work which has been just completed is known as present perfect tense. Like I have eaten rice. And it is also work that has been repeated several times since the past. Like I have been to Kashmir twice. He has been to Guwahati three times. These are all the examples of present perfect tense. And it is also a tense which has started late and is still continuing. Like they have lived in this house for 2 years. So these are all present perfect tense. Now let's know the formula. How does the formula goes? Subject plus has have plus third form of the verb. Subject plus have has plus V3. Do you understand what is V3? Verb 3, V3. V3 means like eat, ate, eaten. It is first form of the verb V1, then V2 is ate and V3 is eaten. So here it will be like I have. What will come? I have. It will go into the third form. So eat, ate, eaten. I have eaten rice. I have, we have, you have, you have, he has, they have. Only in case of third person singular number, you have to use the word has. Like he has eaten rice. Now let's move on to the next one, present perfect continuous tense. What is present perfect continuous tense? Action that has begun in the past and is continuing, and it may extend up to the future also. Like I have been working in this institution since 2015. Means till now I am working and I may be working in the future also. This is known as present perfect continuous tense. To understand present perfect continuous tense is very easy, because most of the time you will find words like since and for. Now I will just explain to you what is since, how it is used and what is for. Very easy. Since is a word which is not mathematical, so he cannot calculate the exact time. Like he will say that I have been working in this institution since 2015. That is since. And if I use for, how would I say? I have been working in this institution for 6 years. From 15 to 21 I will count. Like he has been suffering from fever since last Sunday. Now if I use for, I will say he has been suffering from fever for 5 days. This is the only difference between since and for. And so let's write the construction. How the construction goes? Subject plus have, has, plus been, plus verb ing. Now been, do you know? Been is the base form of be. Like be was been. So now you can say that I, then what will come? Have been suffering from fever since last Sunday. for today's video this much. Next, I will be uploading past and future tense. So please keep watching.